So the purpose of a high seas is to study the effects of isolation and confinement. And you should expect that you really will feel differently and respond differently in here than in normal life. And the same will be true of your crewmates.
The most challenging part of the mission right now has been the end of the mission. It's a really crazy, hectic time. We're all kind of running around and working from the moment we get up to the moment we go to bed.
So for me, one of the most memorable things that we've done here is some of the exploration around the HAB.
It becomes a completely different challenge when you have to wear a very cumbersome, very hot, very sticky sort of suit. You realize that even simple tasks are really difficult, like tying your shoe. If it comes untied during a hike, it is so difficult. So you start to take precautions against things like that. I have duct tape over my laces.
Long-term space travel is absolutely possible. There are certainly technical challenges to be overcome. There are certainly human factors to be figured out. That's part of what high seas is for. But I think that overcoming those challenges is just a matter of effort.
My advice to Mission 6 is say yes. If you have an opportunity, whether it's filming or learning a new science skill or flying the drone, go out to a lava tube, whatever it is, say yes, take leadership on things. Honestly, you can come out of here in 8 months learning a ton of stuff.
As the crew engineer, I've had a lot of time to get to know the habitat. We have mostly a loving relationship, but there are times where you can get frustrated. So my advice for the next crew is to stay patient and remember that even though the habitat can kind of take care of itself, that you're a steward for it.